Hi everyone, and welcome to another video. In this video, I will cover creating and installing Big Sur on officially unsupported Mac hardware. Every new release of macOS, Apple is dropping support for older devices. This could be for different reasons. For example, when the hardware simply is not capable to run the new software in a proper and performant way. Often, unfortunately, this is just because Apple doesn't want to invest in testing and support for older hardware. Although Apple does provide support for a fair amount of time, it still feels wrong to stop using perfectly fine hardware and to be pushed to buy something which you don't need. Luckily, for most macOS versions, there are patches or workarounds available that still allow you to run the newer releases on unsupported hardware. In some cases, there is a genuine reason why Apple no longer supports a new release on your hardware, but in most cases, you should be able to still get things going. In this video, we will look into how we can create a bootable USB drive for installation of Big Sur on unsupported Macs, and we'll run through the whole process of the installation as well. Before we get started, I'd like to mention that I also have a blog, jensd.be, where you can find everything that I will cover here in detail. So, if you plan to go through this yourself, I really recommend you to have a look there. Also, if you're interested in this type of videos, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel. There are usually several ways to patch or work around restrictions in the installer that prevents installation on older hardware. For Big Sur specifically, there is Big Mac, for example, or also Micropatcher. For this video, I'll be using that one in combination with Micropatcher Automator. The first step is to get your USB drive prepared. You will need a drive of 16 GB as a minimum. Insert the USB drive into your Mac and start Disk Utility. Set Disk Utility to show all devices, then select your USB drive on the left side and click Erase. In the dialog, give the drive a name. Here I chose Big Sur Install. Then set the file system type to macOS Extended and GUID as partitioning scheme. Then click Erase. Once the drive is prepared, we can go ahead and download Micropatcher Automator. This is a tool with a comfortable GUI written to use Micropatcher. On the GitHub page, for which you can find a link in the description, navigate to Releases and download the latest release. Once the download is complete, open the downloaded DMG file and wait for it to extract. Then right-click the icon and choose Open. This is needed because it's not official Apple-signed software, obviously. Click Open when you get this warning, for the same reason, and click Continue to get started. In this screen, you can choose to either provide a previously downloaded installer or to download it using the tool. I'll go for the second option, as you can see. After entering my password, the download starts and you can grab yourself a coffee as it needs to download roughly 12 gigabytes. Once the download is complete, choose to use these files to create an installer. Select the volume which we created on our USB drive with Disk Utility earlier, Big Sur Install, and continue. Again, you're up for some waiting time. In my case, this took roughly 50 minutes. Success! At this point, the USB drive is ready, and we can go ahead and test if this works to install on my late 2012 iMac. The latest officially supported release for this one is Catalina. insert the drive in the unsupported Mac where you want to install Big Sur, if it's not yet, then reboot and hold the Option or Alt key. After the chime, you should get a boot menu to show up. As you can see, we have three options here. The first is my currently installed system, second has a hedgehog icon, and the third, a USB logo with FEBoot as label. First, go for the third one. It's a bit strange, but as you can see, this immediately powers off the system, but this is completely expected. Repeat the boot process where you hold the Alt or Option key. And this time we need to go for the second option, install macOS Big Sur. If you skip the previous step with EFI boot, you will end up with a forbidden sign here. In the meanwhile, macOS gets started from the USB drive, and after some time we get into recovery. In recovery, you can notice an additional option, post-install Automator. More about this later. I'll do a fresh install, so I'll start disk utility, and as with the USB drive, select to show all devices in disk utility. Then I can select my hard disk and choose erase. Give a name to the drive, choose APFS as file system, and continue to prepare the drive properly. Now we can close disk utility and finally start the installation of Big Sur. Click continue, accept the license agreement, and choose where to install Big Sur. Here we need to select the volume which we just prepared with disk utility. Once more, patience is needed. Depending on the performance of your device, this can take a whole while. If all goes well, you should be greeted with this dialog, which asks you for a few basic questions to set up the OS. After running through these, we're almost done. Although Big Sur is now installed, not everything is working fine just yet. For example, in About This Mac, we can see that the model that is detected is a generic iMac. This will definitely cause issues for updates. Also, and probably even more annoying, is that some hardware is not working fine. As you can see here in my case, Wi-Fi or the airport card is not detected. Remember that additional option after booting from the USB drive for post-install? This is exactly what it is for. So let's reboot once more and hold the Alt Option key and launch the installer again using the second icon. In recovery, now go for the last option. And select the drive to apply the patches on. Once completed, confirm the reboot. And, as you can see, the model looks fine now. And even better, the Wi-Fi or AirPort card got detected and works as expected. That's it. Hopefully this video can help you to extend the life of your Mac. Thanks a lot for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please put a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you're interested in this type of content. Thanks again, and I really hope to see you back here soon.